Hi again, everyone, and welcome to another edition of Nitro Rewind. Glad you can join us, because here's what's coming up. Just in case you missed them on the ESPN2 telecast, we'll rewind back to the final rounds of Top Fuel and Funny Car at the NHRA SuperNationals in Englishtown, New Jersey, and hear from the winners. Spencer Massey picked up another national event win in Top Fuel, while Mike Neff continues to get her done in Funny Car. Plus, the ever-effervescent David Grubnic explains why the upcoming race in Bristol, Tennessee is always one of his favorite stops. Antron Brown, a native of Chesterfield, New Jersey, talks about racing in his home state and looks ahead to what he likes about Thunder Valley. But first, some Nitro trivia. In the 2008 Funny Car Final in Bristol, Tennessee, Melanie Troxell won her first national event in that category. Who was the runner-up? The answer, coming up later. Now, let's rewind back to that great Top Fuel final at the NHRA SuperNationals at Raceway Park in Englishtown, New Jersey. Del Worsham, driving for Alan Abbey, faced Spencer Massey, the hottest item in Top Fuel lately in his Prestone Fram Dragster. Spencer cuts an 065 light. Del's 080 isn't bad, but that was the difference. Spencer's slower 382.1 at 319 clips Del's 381.5 at 322, and that's Spencer's second straight win and his fourth career Top Fuel victory overall. We wanted to hear from Top Fuel's latest power hitter, Spencer Massey, right after the race. Nice going, Spencer. The Funny Car Final was also decided at the starting line, but differently. Mike Neff in the John Force Racing Castrol GTX Mustang lines up against number one qualifier Cruz Pedregon for Snap-on Tools and Wix Filters. Oops, Cruz leaves too soon, gets the red light, and Mike gets the win, his second of 2011. You know, Mike Neff's nickname is Zippy, who zipped his way further ahead of everyone else on the Funny Car points in E-Town. Here's how he described his race day.
Consistency, you know, when you see a car that consistent, I'm not changing anything on my end. They're doing everything exactly the same, and that's why you see the result like that. And the biggest part of that is, you know, the team. Everybody changing all those parts and doing what they do and having it be that consistent is quite remarkable. The most important thing about this race for me is this is Castrol's headquarters. There's 500 people out here, you know, all weekend and today, you know, out here supporting us, rooting us on, a lot of first-timers that never been out here. So to be able to, you know, give them a long day, good day like today was, and give them something to cheer for, see it all work out the way it did, you know, that's
Thanks a lot, Mike. Here are the full throttle point standings now following Englishtown, the eighth race of the 2011 season. In Top Fuel, Del Worsham still number one. Spencer Massey has picked up a couple of spots. He's number two now. Larry Dixon remains third. Tony Schumacher drops a couple down to fourth. Antron Brown remains fifth. In Funny Car, no change whatsoever in the top five. Mike Neff stretched out his lead over number two, Jack Beckman. All right, David Grubnic was jacked when we asked him about heading for the next race in Bristol, Tennessee.
Bristol race is fantastic. We're in the heart of NASCAR country, you know, one of Bruton's premier facilities. But, you know, the people there are fantastic. And yes, coming in with an Australian accent is always a lot of fun. I checked into a motel once in that part of the country, and I wanted to see my driver's license when I was checking into the room. So, and I'm speaking like this in my accent or whatever, so I had my driver's license over, and she's... And this woman's looking at me and says, "You from California?" And I said, "Yes, ma'am." And so anyway, she turns around and looks at her husband and says, "Come out here and listen to this guy talk from California." So, you know, it was like, I've had some funny times, believe me. I've always said, we're in the entertainment business, okay? So, you know, it's our job to entertain a local audience at the racetrack. It's also our job to entertain the television audience and the audience that's watching this, right? we do that primarily, you know, that's our job. But we also race. Once the helmet goes on, it's a totally different, you know, we're a totally different animal. We go out there and race. But interacting with the fans and so forth, yes, it's a lot of fun. You know, people look at us and think that, you know, we're something different. We're not. We're just the average person that's having fun and joking around and so forth. You know, it's hard for me to remember all the stories of interacting with fans. And you know, like going out to the parking lot to get the car, and then some fans are having a pit party out in the parking lot, and I'll just stop and start BSing with them and have a beer or something. You know, and they're just looking at me like, I've got two heads back. And if there's who is that? You know, so, you know, that sort of thing's a way cool. It's fun. It's actually one of the perks of being in the position we're in.
All right, Antron Brown, driver of the Matco Tools Top Fuel Dragster, is a two-time winner in Pro Stock Motorcycle in Englishtown, so it's a no-brainer that the New Jersey homie really digs racing at Raceway Park and also looks forward to his trip to Bristol.
It's fun racing at home, but that's also the racing dog, the family and friends. There's nothing like coming home getting all the support. And the fans love you, and I come back, I eat up all the pizza and cheese sticks that I put 10 pounds on this race car. But you're still better than all support. You turn around, check them all out behind you. That's what I'm talking about. It's no better. No better than that. And that's what I'm talking about coming home to Englishtown, New Jersey. I love it. I love it. I love it to death. Well, I love going to Bristol. Because once you go there and run that short circle track, and it's just tucked right there in between those two hills. And we go up there. I think we went down whole town up. Here in NASCAR, it's not like we come here with that nitro burning top fuel cars and funny cars. I just get pumped up and excited, and the atmosphere is still on top of the hills. The people come out the woodwork, and we get it on to Bristol. That's why they call it Thunder Valley. It's thundering, and we bring the 16,000 horsepower to two cars side by side.
Thanks, AB. All right, here's the answer to our nitro trivia question. Back in 2008, Melanie Troxell won her first national event in Funny Car at the race in Bristol, Tennessee. Who was the runner-up? Yep, Mike Neff. All right, real quick, here's the broadcast information for the upcoming ESPN2 coverage of the 4th Thunder Valley Nationals from Bristol Dragway in Bristol, Tennessee. The days and times that you see on your computer screen, we love going to Thunder Valley. It is always a hoot down in the Volunteer State. And that's going to do it for this edition of Nitro Rewind. Race video provided by the NHRA. Photos courtesy of lookatdragracing.com. Nitro Rewind is a production of John Force Entertainment. And this is Bill Stevens. Catch you next time on Nitro Rewind. And we hope to see you at the races.